This video presents the new hierarchical column element type on how you can create and set up multi-segment columns. ARCHICAD introduces enhancements to the column tool. A column is now a hierarchical element type, which means that the single column element may be composed of multiple segments. If we open the column setting dialog, we can see that the dialog has a new organizational layout that is similar to the layout of other hierarchical tools of ARCHICAD, such as the curtain wall, stair, and railing tool. The left pane of the dialog shows several settings page buttons, while its top right portion shows the settings fields for the column's dimensions, along with a preview window. Below these are situated the various settings panels belonging to the settings page button selected on the left. If we activate the segment page of the dialog and click the multi-segmented button, a list of the column segments is displayed by default, showing the settings of a single segment. Click the Add button below the list to add new segments to the column definition. In our example, we are adding three segments as we are creating a precast corbel column geometry made up of four segments. Information is displayed about various settings in each segment in the list. From left to right, it displays its structure type, the building material of its structure or name of its complex profile, its length, and an icon indicating whether the segment's length is fixed or flexible. In the Structure panel, we can set or modify the settings of the segment selected in the list. The settings of each individual segment may be set independently. Using usual operating system shortcuts, we can select one or multiple segments in the list and modify most of their settings in a single step. The preview window always gives feedback on which segment or segments are selected in the list. Using the shape buttons, we can select the shape of the segment, which may be rectangular, circular, and complex profile, and set its building material, or select the profile to be used. Each segment may be set independently. In our example, we will use rectangular segments. We may specify a veneer for the segment and set its veneer type, thickness, and building material. In this example, we will not have a veneer. On the right side of the panel, we may specify the dimensions of the segment. A new capability is offered by a button on the left of the dimensions fields. If we click the tapered size button, we can define the dimensions of the segment at both ends, thereby achieving a tapered segment geometry. The next pair of buttons define the length type of the segment. We can either have a fixed length, in which case we can specify the exact length of the column segment, or it can have a flexible length. Flexible length segments may change their length when the full height of the column is modified. Let us consider a few examples. In the case of the first column from the left, all segments have a fixed length, so the full height of the column is also fixed and will not change when we try to graphically modify it. In case of a second column, the bottom segment has flexible length, So when we modify the height of the column, the length of this segment dynamically changes, while the lengths of all other segments stay the same. In case of the third column, we make the top segment the only segment with flexible length. So the length of this segment changes dynamically with the change in column height. In case of the fourth column, both the top and bottom segments will have flexible length, in which case we can set a percentage value of how much of the change in column height will be applied to the given segment. The total of all flexible length segments must be 100%. To the right of the percentage field, you can click the arrow pop-up button and select a common value from the list. Let us select the 50% value for the segment. The percentage value of the other flexible length segment will also be automatically modified to 50%. If we now modify the height of the column, we can see that both segments are stretched and the ratio between their lengths stays the same. The segment list contains not only the defined segments, but joins between segments as well. If we select a join in the list, the angle of join buttons in the segment join panel become enabled. In this panel, you may set the angle of join value for the selected join to horizontal, vertical, or custom angle. Additionally, in the column page of the settings dialog, the new End Cuts and Reference Axis panel lets you set angles for the top and bottom of the column. Using these fields, it is possible to set the angle of either end or any join of the column, which may be particularly useful for slanted columns or columns with special geometry. You can select any segment in the segment list and move it to another position by dragging the segment's up and down arrow icon on the left. Additionally, you may select any segment, right-click and activate the Copy Segment command to copy the settings of the segment to the clipboard. Then select another segment, right-click and use the Paste Segment command to transfer the settings of the copied segment to the active segment. Using these commands, you can transfer the settings of segments from one to the other. If the structure of a segment is set to complex profile, and the selected profile includes parametric modifiers, the Profile Offset Modifiers panel becomes enabled and you can set the values of these modifiers for the segment. Additionally, if the segment geometry is set to be tapered, modifiers will be available for both the top and bottom of the column segment. Using parametric complex profiles in multi-segment columns provides very impressive geometric capabilities. It is also possible to save columns and column segments as favorites. If you activate the Favorites button on the column page, the whole column will be saved as a favorite. And if you activate the Favorites button while on the Segment page, only the selected segment will be saved as a favorite. Please note that only individual segments of the column may be saved as a favorite, but not a series of segments. Please watch all other clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the enhancements made to the column and beam tools of ARCHICAD.